एंड द लास्ट लेक्चर वी स्टडीड अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ सिंथेटिक फाइबर. फर्स्टली वी स्टडीड अबाउट रेयॉन एंड हाउ रेयॉन इज ऑब्टेन्ड एंड व्हाट आर द यूजेस ऑफ रेयॉन एंड हाउ रेयॉन विच साइंटिस्ट डिस्कवर्ड रेयॉन एंड व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड आर्टिफिशियल सिल्क. आई एम रिवाइजिंग टाइप्स ऑफ सिंथेटिक फाइबर. फर्स्ट इज रेयॉन. सो एज वी स्टडीड इन क्लास 7th, सिल्क फाइबर इज ऑब्टेन्ड फ्रॉम द सिल्क वर्म एंड दिस सिल्क फाइबर इज डिस्कवर्ड इन चाइना एंड दिस सिल्क फाइबर इज अ वेरी शाइनिंग फाइबर एंड people like it very much and purchased many silk fibers, but the silk fiber obtained from silkworm was very costly, and so scientists discovered another type of silk, and this is made by wood pulp, and this is called artificial silk or rayon. So when we add some chemicals in the wood pulp, and then after adding some chemicals in the wood pulp, the rayon is obtained. And what is another name of rayon? Artificial silk is another name of rayon. So it is obtained from the natural source. And what is the natural source? Wood pulp is the natural source. But it is called man-made fiber. But it is called man-made fiber. And what is the use of rayon? When it is mixed with cotton, it is used to make bed sheets. And when it is mixed with wool, it is used to make carpet. So this is the figure 3.4. This is the use of nylon fiber. When rayon is mixed with cotton, and it is used to make bed sheets. And when it is mixed with wool, and it is used to make carpet. So what are synthetic fiber? First is rayon. So how rayon is obtained? And what is another name of rayon? Artificial silk is another name of rayon. And how rayon is obtained? When we add some chemicals in the wood pulp, then artificial silk is obtained. And silk fiber obtained from the silk worm, and it was discovered in China. And this silk fiber obtained from silkworm was very costly. So scientists discovered another silk, and this is made by adding some chemicals into the wood pulp, and this is called rayon. And this is also called artificial silk. And this is a synthetic fiber. And what are the use of rayon? It is the rayon fiber, when rayon is mixed with cotton, it is used to make bed sheets. And when it is mixed with wool, it is used to make carpets. So this is the rayon. And next is nylon. As nylon is also a synthetic fiber, as we discussed in previous class, a nylon is also a synthetic fiber, and it is made in 1931. And this fiber is a fully synthetic fiber. This fiber is a synthetic fiber. Why it is called fully synthetic fiber? Because it is made without using any natural substance. And this was made without using any natural substance. So it is called fully synthetic fiber. And how nylon is prepared? Nylon is prepared from coal, water and air. So how it is prepared? It is prepared from coal and water and air. So there are three questions arises. In which year nylon was discovered? In 1931, nylon was discovered. And second question is, why nylon called fully synthetic fiber? Because when the nylon was prepared, no natural material is used. So it is called fully synthetic fiber. Next question is, how nylon is prepared? Nylon is prepared from coal, water, and air. So there are three questions arises in the first passage. And next is, what are the characteristics of nylon fiber? Nylon fiber is a very strong fiber and it is also elastic and it is also very light and it is very lustrous. Lustrous means it is very shining and it is easy to wash, so it can be easily washed. So it became very popular for making clothes. As we know, it is easy to wash. So nylon fiber is very used for making clothes. So what are the characteristics of nylon fiber? It is very strong fiber and it is very light fiber and it is very elastic fiber and it is very lustrous and it can be easily washed. So next question is, why nylon become popular for making clothes? Because it is very easy to wash and it is very lustrous. So it became very popular for making clothes. So there are two questions arises. What are the characteristics of nylon fiber? Nylon fiber is a very strong fiber and it is very elastic fiber. And it is very light fiber and it is very lustrous and it can be easily washed. And next question is, why nylon became very popular for making clothes? Because nylon fiber is very lustrous and can be easily washed. So it become very popular for making clothes. And what are the uses of nylon? Which article are made from the nylon material? We use socks, ropes, tents, toothbrush, car seat belt, sleeping bags, curtains. These are all made from the nylon. So this is a picture, figure 3.3. There is a socks, rope, and toothbrush and curtains. These all articles are made from the nylon. So these are the articles made from the nylon. So there's a question arise. Write four articles made from the nylon. And what are these articles? First is socks, ropes, toothbrush, and curtains. Because as we know, nylon fiber is a very strong fiber. Nylon fiber is a very strong fiber. So it is also used for making parachutes and ropes and ropes of rock climbing, as shown in the figure 3.4. It is used in the parachute and it is used for the ropes of rock climbing. Why it is used in parachute and why it is used for the ropes? Because it is very strong fiber. So it is used for making parachutes and ropes for rock climbing. As we know, when we compare steel wire with the nylon, nylon thread is very, very stronger as compared to steel wire. So nylon thread is very stronger as compared to steel wire. So these are the uses of nylon fibers. Figure 3.4 is the uses of nylon fibers. So these are used for making parachutes, and these are also used for rock climbing. So when we compare nylon thread with the steel wire, then the nylon thread is stronger as compared to steel wire. So there are two questions arises. Why nylon fiber is used for making parachutes and ropes for rock climbing? Answer is because it is a very strong fiber. So it is used for making parachutes and ropes for rock climbing. And next question is, out of steel and nylon, which is stronger? A nylon thread is stronger as compared to steel wire. So you have to write all these internal questions in your notebook. This is the activity 3.1. For the activity 3.1, you have to take iron strand. And this iron strand is available in our laboratory. And as shown in the figure 3.5, this is an iron strand. And then we take a cotton thread. And what is the length of this cotton thread? 60 centimeter is the length of cotton thread. So 60 centimeter is the length of cotton thread. Next is tie it to the clamp so that it hangs freely from it, as shown in the figure 3.5. This is an iron strand. Firstly, we will take a cotton thread and tie this cotton thread with the clamp as shown in the figure. This is the cotton thread, and this is attached with the clamp on the strand. And next, at the free end, suspend a pan so that weights can be placed on it. In the figure, when we add a thread to the clamp, then at the end, we use pan such that weight can be added in the pan. So there is a pan attached with the thread as shown in the figure. And this is a pan used for adding weight in the pan. And next, then we add some weight one by one. When we add some weight, and after adding some weight, the thread breaks. And when the thread breaks, then we note down these total weight required to break the thread. And when we add weight one by one, then thread breaks. And when the thread breaks, you note down the total weight. And then repeat this activity for different threads, just like wool, just like polyester, just like silk, and just like nylon. So this is the observation table 3.2. There are four different types of thread, and this is the total weight required to break the thread. When we take cotton, and when we add some weight, and then the cotton fiber breaks, we note down the reading of weight and put in the table 3.2. When we again repeat this process for wool, silk, and nylon. So this is the activity for observing total weight required to break a fiber. Firstly, we will take an iron strand and then tie a cotton thread and then add a pan, and we can add some weight into the pan so that this fiber breaks. Then we note down the reading on which this thread breaks, and this activity can be repeated for many fibers, just like polyester, just like wool, just like silk, and just like nylon. And if the pan is not present and this activity can be done at your home, firstly we will take a fiber and polythene bag and we hook a nail on the wall for hanging the fiber. Firstly we will take a nail and then tie the fiber with the nail and add weight in the polythene bag. We can use marble instead of weights. If weight is not present, then we can add marbles for adding weight. So if this clamp stand is not available in at your home and this pan is also not available in all your home and this weight is also not present in your home, so we can do this activity at your home. And how it can be done? Firstly, we will take a nail and we attach some fiber into the nail and add some weight, and instead of weight we can use marbles, and note down the readings when the thread breaks and then note down these readings. And when we do this experiment, one precaution kept: firstly, all threads should be of same length. A wool, cotton, silk, nylon, the used material in this activity, all threads should be of same length and almost of same thickness. When we use the all thread of same length and same thickness, then this experiment can be done accurately. If we use different fiber of different length, then this experiment cannot be done by accurately. So next synthetic fiber is polyester fiber and acrylic fiber. And in the previous lecture, we studied about the nylon fiber. And in the next fiber is polyester and acrylic fiber. So this polyester is another synthetic fiber. Fabric made from these fiber does not get wrinkled easily. So what are the characteristics of polyester fiber? When fabric made from these fiber does not get wrinkled easily, and it does not crisp also, and it can also be easily washed. So what are the characteristics of polyester fiber? It does not get wrinkled easily, and it can be easily washed, and it remains crisp. So it is quite suitable for making dress material. So there are two question arises: which material is used for making dress material? Which fabric is used for making dress material? Then polyester is used for making dress material. And why it is used? Because it can be easily washed, and it remains crisp, and it does not get wrinkled easily. You must have seen people wearing nice polyester shirts and other dresses. Terrylene is popular polyester. As we see, many shirts made up of polyester. And what are the example of polyester? Terrylene is a popular polyester. So it can be drawn into very, very fine fibers that can be woven like any other yarn. So when we take terrylene, then its fine fiber can be obtained. And a small fiber can be obtained of the material terrylene. So there are three questions arises: what are the characteristics of polyester fiber? And what are the characteristics of polyester fiber? Fabric made from these fiber does not get wrinkled easily. Second is, it is easy to wash. And third is, it remains crisp. एंड नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाई पॉलिएस्टर इज यूज्ड फॉर मेकिंग ड्रेस मटेरियल बिकॉज ऑफ थ्री कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स दिस डज नॉट क्रिंकल इजिली एंड इट रिमेन्स क्रिस्प एंड इट इज इजी टू वॉश सो इट इज यूज्ड फॉर मेकिंग ड्रेस मटेरियल्स सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज द पॉपुलर फॉर्म ऑफ पॉलिएस्टर Tarryline is a popular polyester. Tarryline is a popular polyester. And what are the characteristics of this tarryline? The fine fiber of tarryline can be obtained. A very small fine fiber of tarryline can be obtained. My mother always buy pet bottles and pet jars for storing rice and sugar. I wonder what pet is. Paheli said that my mother always buy pet bottles and pet jars. And what is the use of these bottles and what is the use of these jars? These are used for storing rice and sugar. So I wonder what pat is. What is the meaning of pat, and how it is used? Pat. What is the meaning of pat, and what is the use of these pat bottles and pat jars? Pat bottles and pat jars are used for storing rice and sugar. So what do you mean by pat? It is a very familiar form of polyester. It is a form of polyester. And what is the use of PET? It is used for making bottles and utensils, wires, and many other useful products. So these are the different material made from the PET, bottles, utensils, wires and many useful products. This is a very familiar form of the PET. This is very familiar form of the polyester. So what do we mean by polyester? Poly plus ester. When ester is a chemical. Ester is a chemical. When we add ester one by one, ester plus ester plus ester, then this will make polyester. Poly means many, ester means chemical. When we take chemical of ester many times, then it will make polyester. And what do you mean by ester? Ester are chemicals which give fruits their smell. Their smell is just like fruit smell. So ester are chemical and their smell is similar to the fruit smell. Fabric are sold by names like polycot, polywool, terrycot. As the name suggests, these are made by mixing two types of fiber. Polycot is a mixture of polyester plus cotton. And polywool is a mixture of polyester and wool. So what do you mean by ester and what do you mean by polyester? Ester is a chemical and it has smell similar to the smell of fruits. So esters are chemical and its smell is similar to the fruit smell. So these the fabric are sold. So polyester is a, what do you mean by ester? Ester are chemicals and these chemicals are obtained. These are chemical which give fruit their smell. So fabrics are sold by the names like polycot. So there are so many fabric present just like polycot, polywood and terrycot. So how polycot is made and how polywood is made? Polycot. Polycot means poly plus coat. Means it is made up of polyester plus cotton. And what is the meaning of polywool? Poly plus wool. It is mixture of polyester plus wool. So So you have to learn these terms. What do you mean by polycoat? Poly plus coat. And it is a mixture of polyester plus cotton. And what do you mean by polywool? Poly plus wool. It is mixture of polyester and wool. So what is the use of PET? It is used for making bottles, utensils, and wires, and many other useful products. And what do you mean by ester? Ester is a chemical which have smell similar to the fruits. So what do you mean by polyester? When we repeat chemical of ester, then polyester is made. And what do you meaning of polycoat? Poly plus coat. Poly plus cotton means it is a mixture of polyester plus cotton. And what is a mixture of polywood? Poly plus wool. Poly, it is made up of polyester and wool. We wear sweaters and use shawls or blankets in the winter. As we use many shawls and we use sweaters and we use blankets in the season of winter, many of these are not made from natural wool. So these materials, just like shawl and blanket, these are not made from the wool, but they look like wool. They are, how they prepare? They are prepared from another fiber, and this fiber is called acrylic. And this looks like the wool. And the wool obtained from natural source is quite expensive, whereas clothes made from acrylic are relatively cheap. What is the difference between wool and acrylic? The wool obtained from the natural source is very expensive, but the clothes made up of acrylic are quietly cheap. So, and they are also available in the variety of colors. So synthetic fibers are more durable and affordable, which makes them more popular than natural fiber. So which is the popular out of synthetic fiber and natural fiber? Synthetic fiber is popular as compared to natural fiber because it is very less cheap and it can be more durable and can be more affordable. So the synthetic fiber are very popular as compared to the natural fiber. So again, I'm repeating what is the meaning of PET and what are the uses of PET? PET is PET is used for making bottles and utensils and films, wire, and many other products. And what do you mean by PET? It is a familiar form of polyester. So it is a familiar form of polyester, and it is used for making bottles, and it is also used for making utensils. And next is, what do you mean by ester? When it is a chemical similar to the smell, and it has smell similar to the fruit smell. And what do you mean by polyester? When so many acids, it makes polyester. And what do you mean by port? It is the mixture of polyester and cotton. And what do you mean by polywool? It is a mixture of polyester and wool. So in the winter season, we use shawl and blankets. These look like wool are made from the wool, but these are not made from the natural wool. They are prepared with the help of a special fiber, and this fiber is acrylic. So the blanket and sweaters and shawls are made up of which fiber? Acrylic. This is a synthetic fiber. So these are all made from the synthetic fiber, and this synthetic fiber is acrylic. What is the difference between the natural source and the synthetic fiber? The wool obtained from the natural source is quite expensive as compared to the cloth of acrylic. So why we use cloth of acrylic as compared to natural cloth made up of natural wool? Because cloth made up of acrylic are quite cheap as compared to the cloth obtained from the natural wool. So next question is, out of synthetic fiber and natural fiber, which is more popular? Natural fibers are more durable as compared to the natural fiber, as these are more affordable and these are more durable. So next is, you have already performed an activity of burning candle and synthetic fiber as we do in the class 7. We do an activity of natural and synthetic fiber. What did you observe when you burn synthetic fiber as compared to the natural fiber? What you will find? You find that their behavior is different from that of natural fiber. So when we burn synthetic fiber, their behavior is very different from natural fiber. You must have noticed that synthetic fiber melts on heating. When we do an experiment of natural fiber and synthetic fiber, their behavior is very different as compared to natural fiber. And what are the difference? When synthetic fiber burns, it melts on heating. And this is a disadvantage of synthetic fiber. And what is the disadvantage of synthetic fiber? When we burn synthetic fiber, it melts on heating. When we heat the synthetic fiber, it melts. And if the clothes catch fire, it can be disastrous. If we wear clothes of synthetic fiber and there is a fire around you, then the synthetic fiber can catch fire. And many big explosion can be occur. And the fabric melts and stick to the body of the person wearing it. So these are two disadvantages of synthetic fiber. And what are the disadvantages of synthetic fiber? First is, it melts on heating. When we wear clothes of synthetic fiber, then